since I got the last letter from Richard. In it, he seemed very distressed and confused. He was writing about strange figures coming to the castle, events that didn't make sense and other weird stuff. At the beginning, I thought he was just overworked or perhaps even paranoid, but then he stopped replying to my letters. I tried to contact him many times, but with no success. 2 weeks later, Richard's employer, Lord Phillips, sent me a brief note saying that my brother's left the castle, that he was feeling sick and wanted to take some time off. But it did not sound like my brother at all. How am I going to find out? At the end, it wasn't that hard to deceive him. I just changed my name and pretended that I was interested in my brother's job. I was determined to figure it all out. I came here to find my brother and bring him home no matter what. I'd like to know what the big secret was that my brother tried to uncover so desperately. Where did he go and why hasn't he come back? He must have been right about something, I'm certain of it. What the hell is going on in here and where's my brother?
Thank you. Would you be so kind and clean up the bloody mess from the floor? It stinks so much and I can't sleep. Please, do me this favor, and you'll get something in return.
I don't want to disturb her.
Thank you so much. Finally, I can get some well-deserved rest. Here, as I promised.
My dog Mary has disappeared. I've been so...
Find it. Make it whole again.
Richard is gone.
Thank you.
usually start with psychological torture. Did you, Discredo? The prisoner, my special invention.
Must have opened the door.
Yeah!
Where is this place? I should be careful.
What did I put myself into?
They are torturing and killing people here. As far as I know, my brother wasn't among them. Lord Philip must have done something to him. Perhaps there's another prison somewhere else. Behind the cave-in, there's the entrance to the old castle wing. Maybe it's there.
Ha 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 ha!
No, it can't be. Richard, no, 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 Richard, no! But no, he was stubborn as always and paid the highest price. What am I supposed to do now? I can't go back. I can't leave this place anymore. Not after all I know. There's only one way and it leads further. I need to find the office my brother was talking about and then decide what to do next. It's locked.
Thank you.
I entered the office. The smell of old books and parchment was quite familiar. I remembered how I used to sit with my brother in our library and listen to his voice. At that moment, my pain was even bigger. I agreed with my brother unconditionally, even though I knew that the prisoners inflicted the same pain on their own victims. They were murderers, they killed and raped. One of them even burned the whole village with women and children calm and sleeping in their beds. Hundreds of people died by the merciless hands, and many others still could, if it wasn't for governmental interference and help of Lord Philip. But that didn't give them the right to play God. They were jury, judge, and executioner in one. I came closer to the table and saw Father. Project Distortion was written on the cover. I opened it and for seconds stood petrified. Hundreds of pages with different torturing methods. The whole list of every prisoner that was held in this castle. And at the end, binding contract with the government and the signature of the king himself. At that moment I thought my task was impossible, but I was still determined to follow it through. In the memory of my brother's lost life, they will be punished. I took the file and ran as fast as I could. I sent a copy of the project to every influential lord in the country. The government immediately declined any connection with the torture. They got rid of all the evidence I could ever acquire. They announced that it was only a way how to discredit the government. Of course, everyone believed them, and those who didn't were too afraid to say anything. At the end, Lord Philip was blamed for everything. He was accused of treason and executed in front of all those he served that well. Where was justice in that? The point was that while the king was preparing other projects with someone else. After so many years, the only thing left are your pictures, memories we used to share. Even now I still doubt if I made the right decision. But is there something as the right decision here? It was my decision. That's what counts, no matter the result. I did what I thought was right, and I have to live with it.